Hello friends, how are you? I hope you all are good. Now in today's lecture, we are going to start our new topic, that is carbon and its compound. So this topic, carbon and its compounds, basically so much important topic. If you are considering this topic as a basic topic for the preparation of organic chemistry. So basically organic is what? Chemistry of carbon compounds. Okay, and in 10th topic, okay, in your 10th standard, or we can say in your homeobha also, this topic, carbon and its compounds. Okay, so very, very much important. Okay, whatever nowadays discoveries will happen in medicines, in in all other areas. Okay, so because of this single carbon only. Okay, so it is a basic preparation of to study of organic chemistry. And it is organic chemistry, separate part in your 11th and 12th standard, okay, for the preparation of competitive exams. So this topic very much important, okay, or we call it as a what? Basic need, understood. So this topic, your carbon and its compound. So here, your carbon. So first know what is carbon. Where it is situated, okay, as you saw our periodic table, okay, carbon family, you know where it is in group 14. Yes, carbon family, Kasi, Gaye, Shankar, Parvati, carbon. So carbon atomic number 6, okay, so electron configuration what? 2, 4, and from this we considering or we conclude that your 4 is what? Valency of your carbon. Okay. 2, 4 is what? Your electronic configuration. Understood. So, it is a versatile element. Basically, what better here? Versatile element. Okay. Now, what will happen? Whatever this study of this carbon, okay, it belongs to separate branch of chemistry. So, now only I discuss that separate branch of chemistry is what? Yes, organic chemistry, that is chemistry of carbon. Understood. So carefully listen whatever topic, very, very much important. Okay, means it is a basic preparation of your higher standard also. Okay, so now we will discuss some here introductory part for this year topic, carbon and its compound. Okay, so see here, introduction. So basically, what we have to discuss in this introduction part. Okay, so basically the compounds obtained from carbon. Okay, so the compounds obtained from carbon are widely used in where? In clothes, medicine, foods, okay, books, fertilizers, fuel, etc. So whatever all living structures, okay, are you listening this point? What are all living structures are what? Carbon based. All living structures are what? Carbon based. Means whatever our body also is what? Carbon based. Understood. So beta, here as you know the basic need of your carbon is what? Yes, carbon, whatever basic information, carbon is non-metal, okay, having atomic number 6 to electron configuration 2, 4. Okay, so these are what basic information regarding your carbon. So now we will discuss here about carbon. We will discuss, okay, where it is occurrence, okay, occur. So beta, here carbon mainly present as its hydrides, mainly present as its hydride. So hydride CH4, these hydrides, okay, these are what? Your carbon hydrides. Understood. Carbon hydride. So we call it as a what? In another way, in another language, hydrocarbons. What beta here? Hydrocarbons, or we can say it is a compounds of what? Hydrogen and carbon. Okay. So as you know beta, here coke. So see here, coke is almost purest form of carbon. Coke is what beta? Is almost purest form of carbon. Okay. And it is obtained from refining of coal. How it is obtained? It is obtained from refining refining of coal. Okay, so very much important here this thing. Now see here, what is the major sources? Okay, so how we can okay, so see here, there are four commonly available forms of carbon. Four commonly available forms of carbon. So which are here available forms of carbon? We can say first we call it as a what beta here? Atmospheric carbon dioxide. Atmospheric what beta here? Atmospheric carbon dioxide, that is what? CO2. Second C here beta, hydrocarbons. Second what? Hydrocarbons. Okay, now what will be here third? Carbonates, like your calcium carbonate, or we call it the what? A limestone. Third is what beta? Calcium, your calcium carbonates. Okay, CaCO3, or we can say what? Limestone. And one of the important ore, that dolomite ore. Next is what beta? Dolomite ore. So dolomite ore is what? It is a mixture of, yes, it is a mixture of what beta? CaCO3 dot MgCO3. CaCO3 dot MgCO3. Understood. And our fourth is what here? We can write fourth. So see here, fourth, fossils fuel. What beta here? Fossil fuels. So beta, in fossil fuels, what will come? Yes, coal, then petroleum. Okay, then natural gas, like a CNG. Okay, so these are what beta? Four commonly available forms of your carbon. So a very much important this part also. Okay, now we will discuss here carbon in daily life. Okay, what beta here? Carbon in daily life, how it occur. Okay, carbon in daily life. So beta here, carbon in daily life, we can write here food. So how in food beta? Yes, your, as you know, proteins, then fats, okay, then carbohydrates, these all contain carbon, and vitamins. Okay, now clothing. So see here, in clothing, how we can, what are the examples here? We can write in where? In clothing. Okay, so see, your cotton. Yes, beta, cotton, then silk, nylon, then terelin, etc. These are what here? Yes, these are what? For clothing. Now see here, packaging. Where beta here? Packaging. So say here, packaging, how we can write? So basically, your, in packaging, how we can use this as a source of carbon? Okay, so see here, we have to write beta what? Yes, wood. Understood. Then paper. Okay, then cellophane. I think, are you heard this first time? This word cellophane is what? Wrapping material. What beta here? Cellophane is a wrapping material. Understood. Cellophane, and we can write here what? Polythene. What beta here? Polythene. Understood. Now fourth, households. Where beta? households. So your carbon, how we can use in households? Okay, as you know beta, PVC, okay, then melamine is what, one of the polymer. Then bakelite, also one of the what polymer means. These all are what beta, polymer. And one separate topic, okay, in 12th standard, polymers, okay, in that all we have to discuss polyvinyl chloride, then melamine, formaldehyde resin, bakelite, okay, these are what, polymers. Also we can use in as a household, these all are, okay. Now suppose you are going to write fuels. So beta, here fuels, so see here, how can we write fuels? So see, fuels, as you know, your petrol, okay, petrol, then diesel, okay, then kerosene, then LPG, then CNG, okay. So these are what beta, all carbon contained. Understood. So carbon in daily lives we use in such a manner. Understood. So here, these are what beta, some daily life we are using carbon in daily life, okay, cooking food material, okay. Understood. So now we are going to discuss here allotropes of carbon. What beta, here allotropes of carbon. So see, in allotropes of carbon, first we have to discuss, okay, what is allotropy? Allotropy means, we call it as a what, bahurupi. In Marathi, what we call, bahurupi. Allotropy means what, bahurupi. So see here, we will write here allotropes of what, carbon. Allotropes of carbon. Okay, so beta, first we will define what is allotropy. So allotropy means what, different forms of an element having same chemical property but different physical properties, okay, are called as what, allotropy, or we can say allotrope. So see, same chemical property but different physical property means some are what, so hard, soft, like that. Okay, now see here, carbon has following allotropic forms. So which are those, we will discuss here, carbon, which allotropic forms. Okay, so we will start here. So carbon, so these are what beta, here your carbon, okay, your carbon here. So after that, first mainly which types? Yes beta, mainly which types here? Okay, which types beta, mainly here? Carbon allotropic, yes, crystalline and amorphous. What beta? First what? Crystalline. Okay, what we can write? Crystalline form. Then what? Yes, here what we have to write? Amorphous form of your carbon. Okay, so again, in crystalline form, having what when we call it as a, this particle is crystalline, okay, because see here, when we called it, they have definite geometrical shape. Whatever your crystalline form, it has what, definite geometrical shape, okay, because of ordered arrangement of atoms, then we call it as a what, crystalline form. Now see, what we have to write in amorphous form. So amorphous form do not have definite geometrical shape. Does not have definite geometrical shape. Okay, and we call it as a word. Irregular arrangement of atoms. Irregular, there is what? Regular, or we can say order arrangement of atom. Here what? Irregular arrangement of atoms. Okay, so here whatever your crystalline form is further divided into where? Diamond, graphite and fullerene. These are what? Further classified. Your this what? Yes, beta. Crystalline form of carbon powder classified into where? Yes, beta, here. Diamond. Then what, beta? Graphite. And what here? Fullerene. Diamond, graphite and fullerene. Okay. And here, where, beta? Yes, in amorphous form. So see here, how we can categorize this first? This first you categorize like this. Okay, say what it is. Lamp black. What better here? Lamp black. Okay, then what here? Charcoal. Charcoal. Then here what? Coal. Okay, then again your charcoal is subcategorized in three subtypes. So see which three subtypes are there. Okay, that also we will write here. Yes, wood charcoal. Here what? Wood charcoal. Then sugar charcoal. And third is what, beta, here? Yes, bone charcoal. Okay, so these are what? Bone charcoal, or we can write here what? Animal charcoal. So these are what? Allotropes of carbon. Okay, we discuss here. Understood? Crystalline amorphous. I hope you understood this all. Okay, now it's time to discuss in briefly structure of diamond. What, beta? Diamond. And what is the structure of diamond? Okay, so that also first, whatever our allotropic forms of carbon, we will discuss now. Okay, so concentrate on this. So first we will discuss here structure. What, beta? Yes, structure of diamond. So ready with this. Okay, so say structure of diamond. Structure of diamond. So basically in crystal structure of diamond, each carbon atom is bonded to four other carbon atoms. In tetrahedron manner. Okay, so the valence of each carbon atom is satisfied in diamond, and there is no free electrons. Okay, so whatever your carbon valence, it is satisfied here. Valence of carbon, how much here? 4. It will be satisfied in the structure of diamond. Okay, so this arrangement of carbon atoms makes diamond. Whatever strongly bond between this carbon atom, it makes diamond very hard, unreactive, and bad conductor of what? Yes, bad conductor of electricity. Okay, now we will discuss here structure of diamond. So see here, I want to draw here structure of diamond. So you concentrate on this, how we can draw this. Okay, so like this, so you have to draw, beta, what? Yes, regular tetrahedron. Okay, say you are concentrating how you have to draw this in your where in your regular chemistry notebook. Okay, now see here how I am drawing this. Okay, so see here, means suppose I have to locate this tetrahedron. So like this, are you concentrating here? Okay, understood. Are you concentrating here? Means tetrahedron geometry, are you observing here? Okay, so like this we have to observe tetrahedron arrangement in your diamond. Okay, so now beta we will discuss properties of diamond. Okay, whatever I am saying, you have to each and every word you have to write it in your notebook. Okay, now see here, we will discuss beta properties of diamond. Okay, so say properties of diamond. Properties of diamond. So now see properties of diamond. So beta, first diamond is what? First is what beta? Diamond. Yes, diamond is transparent and colorless solid. Yes, colorless solid. Okay, its refractive index. Okay, its refractive index about 2.45. What is the meaning of refractive index beta? It is the ratio of velocity of light in vacuum and what velocity in specified medium, that you will discuss in physics, refractive index. Okay, it has some property of refraction of light. Okay, reflect and refraction of light. Okay, so see here, whatever your third what beta? Yes, property, physical properties of your diamond is, okay, having density we will discuss. So density of diamond, so see, density of a diamond, how much is near about 3.51 grams per cm cube, grams per cm cube at 20 degree Celsius. So much important is at when 20 degree Celsius. Okay, now one more here physical property of your diamond. Diamond is hardest natural substance known. Hardest natural substance known. Okay. Now very much important thing here or interesting term is what? Okay, only diamond can cut another diamond. That also you have to mention. Only diamond can cut another diamond. So very much important is an interesting thing about diamond. Okay, and is what beta? As you know, bad conductor of electricity. Okay, and we will discuss here melting point. So beta, melting point, so see here, sixth property, melting point of a diamond is 3550 degree Celsius. Okay, and whatever your diamond, it will not attack by acids, alkalis and solvent like water, ether, benzene. Okay, or your CCl4 also. But diamond, okay, but diamond is attacked by fluorine. Okay, so one of the important property we are going to discuss here about your diamond. It will not attack by any acid, alkali, and even your non-polar solvent like CCl4, but it will attack by fluorine when it heats to 750 degrees Celsius. Okay, now we will discuss that reaction also. So see here, carbon, that is what your diamond, plus what beta, fluorine, 2F2 fluorine, when heated up to 750 degrees Celsius, so what it will form? CF4, carbon tetrafluoride it will form. What beta? Carbon tetrafluoride is formed. Okay, so one of the here we discuss important physical property. Diamond is not attacked by any solvent, but it will react with this fluorine at 750 degrees Celsius. Okay, so whatever our next point, we will discuss it next lecture. Thank you. I hope you understood this all contained. Okay, thank you.